Is the server running on that host and accepting TCP IP connections? You might have seen this kind of error. So in this video, I will give you proper method how can you fix this kind of error. First thing, you need to set up PostgreSQL. There might be a chance that you didn't set up the PostgreSQL, so that's why this error is coming. So first thing, we need to set up our PostgreSQL. If you have already set up and still you are getting error, then watch the complete video and you will know everything. Just search PostgreSQL and go to this site, click on Windows, and here you can see download the installer, click on that. Here you can see some different kind of PostgreSQL version. So here some versions are stable for Windows 64-bit and some are 32-bit. So whatever your computer, download according to that. So just my PC is 64-bit, so I am just clicking on 64-bit PostgreSQL. So here our download is started. Wait for few seconds. Okay, so our PostgreSQL is now completed. So what you can do, just go to your download directory and double click on that exe file. After that, click on next. If you want to change your file selected, then you can do that. I am keeping as it is, so I don't need stack builder. It is for if you need to install additional component, then you can check it or you can uncheck. So I am unchecking it. Click on next. Here you need to enter your password and you must remember this password. I am just putting simple password, admin. Click on next. This is the default port number and this is data cluster. Click on next and it will start downloading. It will start installation process. So wait for a few seconds. In the meantime, we need to install one more package. Pip install psypg2. So I have already installed, so there is no need of reinstall. PostgreSQL is already installed, so just search for pgadmin4 and hit enter. So here you got an error, the pgadmin for server could not be connected. So just copy and paste error I am just doing. This is obviously stack overflow. Best thing, it is developer hurt. We got solution. We need to run as administrator. So just run as administrator. Okay. So it run successfully. Just enter your previous password which you enter in the time of installation. Okay, so we got our admin page, so it needs to be connected to the server, so just enter the server and save password. Okay, so yeah, you can see that our PostgreSQL is activated. So I am just using gfg code. You can direct copy paste that and change your password by your password. And after that, what we need to do? I am using demo as a database. It will, if there is no database with the name of demo, then it will create, else it will use the previous database. So I am just using py demo postgres.py. Here you can say database has been created successfully. Now we connected to the PostgreSQL. So that's it. If you have any different error, then you can tell me. I will try to fix them. So thanks for watching. You will see me in the next video.